today's video, we're going to be talking about Reality Signal. This is a cloud-based VR and collaboration software for the construction industry. I'm going to be showing you how you can take a Revit model, export a file from Revit, then how you can upload it to the cloud, and how you can use that for collaboration and also view it in VR. Let's go! Now, as I said, Reality Signal is a cloud-based collaboration and VR software. So what that means is you can take any one of these file formats, which means that you can use any one of these softwares. And of course, in this video, I'm going to be using Revit. You can export a file from your software of choice, upload it to the cloud, and then it's going to, well, be there as a model on the cloud, and you get all of these collaboration tools. So you can send a link to your clients, colleagues, or anyone. They can open it up in the web browser and they can explore the model. You have some additional tools for collaboration, so you can record videos, you can measure distances, you can create streams, you can just set all of these things up so your colleagues or clients can have an easier way of navigating through the model. So I'm going to be showing you all of this, and then towards the end of the video, I'm going to be showing you the VR capabilities, and we're going to be exploring our model in VR. So if you want to check out Reality Signal, you can do that absolutely for free. So I'm going to link it up in the cards above and then also down in the description of this video so you can try it out for yourself. And now, without any further ado, let's jump straight into Revit. And here we are in Revit. I have my office building project, and this is what I'm going to be using. So now, to get a file ready for Reality Signal, all you have to do is go here to the file menu, then go to export, and you want to pick out the DWF or slash DWFX file format. And then here, you really don't need to set anything up. Everything is already set up correctly. So you just go here to next, you pick out a file location. I'm just going to save it on my desktop. You can pick out the name. And here, I'm just going to make sure this is a DWF file. And then you just click OK. So as soon as that file has been exported, now we can explore this file in Reality Signal. So here I am at the Reality Signal website. So I'm just going to go here to log in, and I'm already logged in. And as you can see, I've already tested out this project. But just to show you the process, what you do is you just go here to new project, you give it a title. So let's call it a house or something like that. Then you want to pick out where the model has been exported from, and here you can see all of the software that's available. I'm just going to set this to Revit because it's a Revit file, and then you just drag your project here. So here I have it on my desktop, so I can just take that file and just drag it over, and as soon as the file has been uploaded, you just go here to upload project, and it's going to start processing. So as you can see, this model is now processing. Usually it takes a few minutes or something like that, and then it's going to be done. But in this case, because we already have the same project already uploaded, I'm going to be exploring that. So you just go here and you can select the private URL or the public URL, depending on who you're going to be sharing this with. In this case, I'm just going to open up the private URL. Here you can see now it's loading, and we can now enter the model. So we can enter it like this on our computer or mobile phone perhaps, or we can enter it on a device. So we can enter it in VR. So here, let's go with our computer now. We can set up the audio because this is overall a collaboration tool. So we want to collaborate, and for that we need our microphone and speakers. So here everything is set up correctly in my case. So now I'm inside of the model. So here we go, I'm in the lobby. So let me just get out of this model so I can show it to you. Okay, so here we go. This is our model loaded in. So now for navigation, it's pretty much like any video game. You can basically just hold your left mouse button and then just kind of move around to just look around. You can use your WS to go forwards and backwards, and then A and D to go left and right. And then also you can use Q and E to kind of look around like this, but I just prefer going like this. And then, of course, depending on the mode you're in, you have this fly mode where you can just go up and down and you can kind of fly around the model, and you can hold the shift key if you want to do it faster. So this is just going forward, this is going forward with shift. Okay, so that's what we have for fly mode. And then if I click here on fly mode and it's just going to be turned off, now I'm in kind of walk mode and I can just kind of walk around the lobby. And as you can see, it is going to recognize obstacles in my way, so it's not going to let me go through this table or something like that. So I actually prefer fly mode because then we can fly through walls and we can navigate through our model easily. Okay, so speaking of all of the options that we have here, let's now go to viewpoints. So depending on who you're sharing this model with, you might want to already set up some viewpoints. So if you're talking to the client, you might say, okay, I want to have this lobby here where kind of the guard is going to be sitting or something like that. So I can just stand here, I can go to viewpoints, and then I can say add a viewpoint, but just let's name it lobby, and it's going to save that viewpoint. And then I can go upstairs, so this is going to be kind of the CEO office over here, nice corner office. So because I want to show the CEO what the view is going to be like, I can then go here and say CEO and then add that viewpoint. So I can save these viewpoints, and then if I'm sharing this with a client or with some colleagues, they can easily navigate through the model by clicking on those viewpoints. So just click there and it's going to kind of transform you through the model, which is quite cool. Moving forward, we have the measure tool. So for example, if you're speaking with a colleague or something, or with a client, and you're kind of examining the model and you're not sure about any distances, you can just go here to the measure tool, and then you can kind of start measuring from here to there. And then you can say, okay, so here, this is that was an accident. So here you can just check, okay, this is 2.4 meters. Okay, that might be enough, and so on and so forth. So you can just play around with the measure tool to just check something on the fly. Then we have the sun settings. So if I just go out a little bit and go to the sun settings, you can see we can set up the sun position around the model, kind of adjusted to where the sun is actually going to be in real life. And then we also have the time of day, so we can set it at sunrise or sunset or anywhere in between. Moving forward, we also have a streaming capabilities. So let's say you're working with a client that's not that tech savvy, yet you want to show them the model remotely. Well, it makes sense just to stream to them, and then you can just walk them through the model and they can ask questions, you can go back, and you're the one that's navigating through the model and they're just watching the stream. This might be really useful in some cases. Now also, you can create a recording. So if I just click here, it's going to start recording. And because I'm using my microphone, I'm using my speakers and everything, I can just go here and I can say, okay, so this is our lobby. And then next to it here, we just have a store. So, and then here we have some stairs and so on and so forth. So basically you can create this recording and you can show things off. So you don't even have to be kind of live with the clients. You can just create a recording and send them the video. And then here I can just save it and it's going to have that video saved. And then we have the webcam, which I can turn on so I can be kind of visible here. The client can see me through the webcam as I'm showing them the model. Now, in this case, I cannot activate that because I'm already using my camera to record myself for this video. But if I wasn't, I would be able to use that. We also have a chat feature, obviously. We also have some music. So if you want to have some music running, that's also possible. And then here we have some model defaults which we can set up. So the sun position, the spawn point, the default movement, and the units. So all of that can be adjusted. And then here we have some more settings where you can set up your avatar, so how people are going to view you in the model. If you're collaborating, if multiple people are in the model, how you're going to appear. We have some preferences, room info, and so on. So this is basically how the collaboration tool works on a PC. Now let's explore what does all of this look like in VR. And now I'm in VR, so I'm just going to hit here, enter room. That's going to bring me inside the model. And here I can now look around. Let me just get out real quick. Okay.
And here we go. So I'm in the model here. You can see we have all of the tools like the mic, the disable fly mode option, the viewports, the measure, the music, which we can turn off, and so on. So I can now just basically fly around the model looking at everything. Okay, this is really cool. So I'm here in the model, and of course you can use the pointers just to navigate to a certain position so you can look from there. So if I go like this, I can just come here, and then of course I can fly. So if I want to go through the building itself, I would just go, wow. Okay, so here we are, we're inside, and then let's go to the CEO office, and then okay, so here we have, this is the elevator and the stairs are there. Okay, I have hands, cool. So let's go through this door here. Oops. So this is the secretary's office, and then this is the CEO room. Okay, so being here in the CEO room, okay, the couches, okay, I'm hitting the table here. Okay, so okay, so yeah, there we go. This is the view, and then I can go to the balcony and see the view from the balcony, and it does look beautiful. There's the parking and everything, and then if I want, I can just come out here and see just how nice the building looks from here. Okay, I feel really unstable when I'm when I'm flying around. Yeah, there we go. So that's what this looks like in VR. I can tell you, it does look really, really impressive. So this was really fun. I've just reviewed the recording, and I can tell you, it doesn't do it justice when you're there in VR. Like, the experience is amazing. And overall, I had a lot of fun with this tool. So I would like to encourage you to check it out. As I said, you can get it now for free. So I think it's worthwhile taking advantage of that. So as I said, the link is going to be up in the cards above, and then also below in the description of this video. And I'll be back with another Balkan Architect tutorial in a few days. Have a nice day.